Behold, my field unto which I grow my fucks. Notice that it is barren, for I have no fucks to give.
Why do women and children evacuate first during any type of disaster? So men can think of a solution in silence.
No thanks.
So you're breaking up with me because I'm too good of a guy. Yeah, I have internalized misogyny and daddy issues, and that's why I just can't be with you. You're not a good person, and I didn't want to be with you in the first place. Actually, that was kind of hot, and I want to stay with you.
I don't care if she's a girl or a baby or somebody's grandmother. I'll still knock her out.
Feminists, where the fuck y'all at? Y'all tried to sabotage my whole internet existence. Got Joe Jonas's bitch posting a video, tried to cancel me because I asked why y'all believe you have it harder than men, and because I said that good men who do good things deserve appreciation for being good people. But Shorty can go on a live a few years ago and admit to taking advantage of her little cousin, and then says while he's crying about it that she been a savage? Oh, that's what you savages do, huh? The video on my Instagram story. Feminists, where the fuck y'all at? So I can't ask y'all a question, but she can openly rape her little cousin and y'all okay with that and keep giving her views and clout. Clowns.
Here's to all the crazy feminists who watched my last video. How to get out of the friend zone. The reason why so many girls are getting upset about my advice on how to get out of the friend zone is because once they find out that you get out of the friend zone, they can no longer use you as free validation and free attention. Sometimes they even get free food or dinner dates. Let's just be honest, the girls know that the guys want to get with them, but they use that just to get free attention from them. Guys, you're gonna see these girls all over social media and on Tinder. They just create these accounts to get guys hitting them up just for attention, when in reality, they only like one guy. I'm gonna be honest, these thoughts must be stopped. So guys, stop entertaining these girls with free attention. Why do you think OnlyFans is doing so successful? Because all these simps just love to give free attention to girls because they have no self-respect and no self-value. They're the same girls who shake their ass on TikTok, but then say, hey, we're not objects. Please respect us. Get the fuck out of here.
I will be okay, just wipe those tears off of your face. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I don't care about your attraction. I don't care about love either. Why do you women think you get it all? What makes you so special that you get it all?
Men get it all the time. So yeah.
No, we don't. And we accept what we get.
That's tragic.
I don't know, ma'am. You got a choice. Because here's the thing. Here's the reality. Are you ready? The reality is what you have to negotiate with right now has a time limit on it. It will spoil. It will get old. And what you have today, it won't be worth the same thing 5 years from now. Because it ain't worth the same thing as it was 5 years ago. So after this is over, because it seems like you have maybe some girlfriends around or people around, I'm not saying this to be hurtful, man, but you got to tone this down and really come down. You're going to have to really ask, what do these men want that I want? And then what matters more? Do you need this, that, that, and attraction, and this?
Look. Hello, welcome to my YouTube channel, guys. Today I am going to make a new video, so please I want to reach 1 million likes. So please, okay, thank you.
Look, I'm not going to lie with you. I've been developing feelings for you. I know you see it. I know it. I've been seeing how all these guys treating you and they're using you for your body. And you, honestly, you deserve more than that. And, you know, I really feel something for you. I hope you feel the same way.
Oh, that's so sweet. Honestly, I only see you as a brother, though. But you have everything I could ever wish for in a boyfriend. You're loyal, you communicate, you respect me. You're just everything I wish I could have in a boyfriend. But you're just a brother to me.
Wait, what? If I'm everything you want, am I? Hey, yo, Ma, look, listen. I'm gonna abuse the fuck out you. I really don't care about you. If you say you love me, I really don't love you back. You know, I'm gonna go cheat on you and shit. But, like, you better not go talk to other guys, though. Like, I can talk to women, but you can't, all right? Like, I'm gonna beat the fuck out you, alright? Like, crew.
Oh my, you're perfect.
Yo, legit, what the fuck is wrong with you?
She making sure her makeup is on point. She take extra care on the makeup, on the wingtips, all that shit. And some of y'all are like, oh well, she just wants to look good. She's only going out, she wants to look good. She's a female, she should want to look good. You're right. But tell me this, how come she don't even do that shit for you when y'all go on dates? Aren't you supposed to be together? Aren't y'all in a relationship? Shouldn't she be focused on you for that? If anything, that's the point in time where she should be really getting ready for your ass. But she do that to go to work. She look like she going on a date going to work. She just wearing scrubs. She's single as fuck. And then y'all ask why. Well, why is she doing this? Why is this happening? You notice different behaviors. Wake up call. She is doing this for the guy that she's going to encounter. Maybe it's already at the workplace.
Since so many guys ask women what...
A bunch of people asked me to review this even though I've done her twice. I consider her a soft target because she's an idiot. First off, this is a deflection. She's already been asked this. She tried to answer in her first video, which is previous, that women bring sex to the table. Although we've demonstrated conclusively that women are fairly bad at sex, and she's not demonstrating that she's got any skill either. But by establishing an employee-style contract, she doesn't realize it's not just that you have to show up. You have to show up and perform, just like you have to do at a job. Which means a performance evaluation can get you fired. Secondly, of course, this is a deflection. She hasn't actually managed to talk about anything that women bring to the table. And like any employee interview, she's essentially interviewing, and when someone says, what do you bring to my position that I'm hiring for, she has no answer. She's attempting to deflect, which is really pathetic. Unfortunately, she's also spent several months establishing the answer to her question. According to her, men bring material wealth to the table. That's her entire shtick. Apparently, she doesn't bring intellectual stimulation to the table either.
Does anyone's boyfriend sit in the car for a long time before coming inside? It makes me sad. Maybe he doesn't like coming home to me. Maybe I...
It sucks that a lot of girls on this app think that they know boys a lot more than boys know boys, so I'm just gonna explain something real quick. Chris Rock once said, only women, children, and dogs are loved unconditionally. A man is only loved under the condition that he provides something. You can't deny it, but that is true. That is really true. And after a long day of providing, you kind of tend to need a break. So what do guys do when they need a break? Because I guarantee you they're not going to break down in front of their whole family. They're gonna sit in a car when they're alone and no one is around to judge them or tell them that they need to be doing this or that. Honestly, if a guy is sitting in his car for a long time and the first thing that comes to your mind is, well, he's deleting messages, he has to be cheating, then that sounds like a you problem. That sounds like an insecurity that you are pushing out. Dad's in the car for a long time, the same reason as why mom's at the grocery store for a long time. Everyone needs a break.
Yeah, this right here makes you goofy as fuck. You can have access to all her social media accounts, the password to her phone, but if a girl wants to cheat, she gonna cheat. It is not your responsibility to stop her. Keeping a leash on her is insecure and lame as hell. What you gotta do is the sensible thing. You gotta cheat first, baby. Stay toxic.
You ever wondered, like, damn, why am I such a simp? Where did my simp characteristics come from? I'm gonna give you the source right here. Stay tuned. One, you was raised by a single mother, your aunts, your grandmother, probably your dad was in your life or her daddy worked a lot, right? So when you're raised around a feminine woman, you're gonna adapt feminine qualities. See, some of the feminine traits you adopted is you're insecure, you're jealous, you're controlling, you require a lot of attention, you want to text your girl 24/7, you want to be around her 24/7. These are feminine traits. Your relationship requires balance. There's masculinity and there's femininity. The girl's the feminine one, the guy's the masculine one. Without this, there's no relationship. Okay, maybe I dragged it. You might get that relationship with the girl you want, but once she sees the feminine energy, she's gonna leave you or cheat on you and go seek that masculine energy from another man. And this is why a woman cannot raise a man. She can raise a good guy, but she cannot raise a man. Every man needs a father figure or a father in his life. Fellas, listen up to this. See, I can feed you to fish with these women videos, but if you want to learn how to fish and reel them in, DM me now to schedule a one-on-one call. Let's get it.
She not worth it, bro. Shooting on the camera, put your mask on.
I get that call. The one that impregnated you once or twice.
He went to jail.
Oh, so you pick ass whoopers and felons. And then you're gonna complain about I need you to stop right here, ma'am. I need you to slow the whole. I need you to slow the whole around. Let you black women just sit around and talk about it. Black men ain't here and ain't this, they ain't that. When in your own life, you pick shit.
Yo, purple sex, Molly, purple sex.